Justin. Justin, I'm delighted you're here. Who else? I'm just kind of looking at our gallery here this morning. Dave and Linda, I believe, waving at us. So we're delighted that you're here with us, and I see Justin's responding back that he's glad to be here as well. So in a minute, we'll start and we'll get on with our service and the continuation in a very different way of our theme of grace. community of Payson. And I heard some of those good mornings even from those of you who are joining us virtually. I'm Reverend Neil Worthington, and welcome to Unity of Payson. It's a special day today because it is the fifth Sunday, and whenever we have a fifth Sunday, the members of Unity of Payson share with us. They usually share along the theme that we are celebrating, and that theme, of course, is grace this month. So three of our number will share with us this morning about their lives and how grace has been active in their lives. Would you join me for a moment of opening prayer? So come together, center, be here now. As we say, God of all goodness, we are grateful for the grace that is the very nature, the very substance of the universe, and that's limitless and always available to us. So for all of the graces, like the earth, that blue boat that we're on, for the graces of others in our lives, for the grace of sharing that we have, being an expression of divine grace, we are grateful. Bless everyone who is with us here this morning, has joined with us, a symbol of the oneness that we are, the connection that we have. We are so grateful, and so it is. Amen. So on this fifth Sunday, I get to be the platform host because there's other things that I don't have to do. So this morning, I will be your platform host, and we're going to have an opening song that we'll share together here. The song is by Cat Stevens. If you want to sing out, so sing along if you'd like. The text will be there, the lyrics, and we'll sing this. If you want to sing out, is our opening song.
Well, if you want to sing out, sing out. And if you want to be free, be free. There's a million things to be, you know that there are. And if you want to live high, live high. And if you want to live low, live low. 'Cause there's a million ways to go, you know that there are. You can do what you want, the opportunities are. If you find a new way, you can do it today. You can make it all true, and you can make it undo. You see, ah, it's easy. Ah, you only need to know. Well, if you want to say yes, say yes. And if you want to say no, 'cause there's a million ways to go, you know that there are. And if you want to be me, be me. And if you want to be you, 'cause there's a million things to do, you know that there are. You can do what you want, the opportunity's on. And if you find a new way, you can do it today. You can make it all true, and you can make it undo. You see, ah, it's easy. Ah, you only need to know. Well, if you want to sing out, sing out. And if you want to be free, be free. 'Cause there's a million things to be. You know that there are, 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 you know that there are. You know that there are.
possibilities that there are. Cat Steven introduced us to those, and remembering that divine grace in unlimited measure is available to us all. Well, I want to welcome everybody who's with us here this morning, both of you, both those of you who are with us here in person and those of you who are with us online. We're glad that you're with us, and since we're all together and you're online, if you can do this, just enter into the chat if you're able, where you're joining us from. We'd be delighted to know. We invite you to remain after the service. What we'll do is have our service as it's planned, this unique service, but then we'll take just a 5-minute break, and then we'll come back for a conversation. And for those of you online, you can converse with us. And for those of you here, you can converse with those who are online. So we'll enjoy that time together after the service, just to share maybe something that's inspired you from the service or something you have to share with this community. If you are not one who receives our weekly newsletter, I encourage you to either put in the chat or to go to unityofpayson.org and that contact area, or somehow let me know that you'd like to receive that, because there are so many things happening here at Unity Payson. We're excited about them, and we hope you can join some of those in on some of those as well. So for those of us who are here regularly, we say this to each other, and we also say that to those who are joining us perhaps for the first time or haven't been with us so much, and even those that haven't found us yet, energetically we're saying this, and we do it together. Let's say this together. Charge it up with energy. I see Betty over here charging it up. We love you. We bless you. We welcome you. Time for gratitude. There are so many things to be grateful for. And here at Unity of Payson, we're grateful for all of those who support this ministry, Unity of Payson, with their time, their talents, their treasures. And we're grateful for the events that happened this last week. If you haven't been here much, you'll begin to realize that Unity of Payson is more than just this Sunday service. There's an awful lot of things that are happening. And the things that happened this last week that we're grateful for is, of course, Morning Cafe, which happens every morning at 9:30. Online. Virtually, we meet together and get a good start for the day. Then, of course, Qigong Tai Chi, led by Teresa. Organic gardening. If you haven't ever connected with Ram and you're here in Payson, if you're here from afar, that's going to be a difficult one. But if you can, go down to Shanti Olmsted and connect with Ram about the organic farm that's there and that wonderful experience, a very spiritual place. I know you'll enjoy it. We had a new thing that we're supporting here at Unity of Payson. That's the kindness movement project. We haven't even figured out what it's going to be yet. But Monday we all met. There were about 20 of us that met in a hybrid fashion for a conversation. We had conversation around the idea of kindness, and more about that later. Writers group, which was on Thursday of this week, for those who love to write. And then spiritual cinema was on Friday night. For all of these things, we are grateful, and also for the technology and the people who work with it, like Tom. You don't know, but we come here early every Sunday morning, hoping that all the links fall into place and that we'll be able to share our experience with those both online and here in person. Unity is grounded in affirmative prayer and meditation, and so this focus is something we take very seriously, and we have trained prayer chaplains. Let's see, we've got two of them here this morning in person, and others waiting in the wings to support you in prayer. If you have a prayer need or a prayer desire, make sure to contact us and let us know. If you're here in person today, tap either Betty or Marianne on the shoulder. You can spend a little time and have them pray with you. If you're here with us virtually, or you'd like us to connect with you during the week, let me know. My address is on the screen, neil.unityofpayson@gmail.com. Let me know of your prayer requests, and we're glad to hold you up. What happens is we pray over those prayer requests for a month, for 30 days, here at Unity of Payson with our prayer chaplains, and then we send them on to Silent Unity, where they're prayed over for another 30 days. So you are bathed in prayer when we're able to support you and the request that you have. So we are now continuing. We'll move on to our theme for, you can see I'm not quite as fluid as our usual platform people. We move on to our theme for the month, and the month is just about over, but we've been having this theme, the theme of grace. And I like it when we just say that affirmation, which is at the bottom of the screen. So even if you're with us virtually, say this with us. I am transformed as I receive and extend divine grace. Today's speakers, not just speaker, is the members of Unity of Payson. There are three people that we're going to share. I'm not sure if Frosty is able to be with us. We have not seen her yet. Something may have taken her away. So it may be two speakers this morning. Sylvia and Rick will be speaking, and they'll be speaking from this location. And they're talking about grace in their lives. They're going to speak from their heart the experience that relate to grace. More than anything, share their lives, their heart with you. So we look forward to that. Every Sunday we read the Daily Word. Take just a moment to reflect on that. So it's time for the Daily Word. The word is prosperity today. The affirmation, I broaden my perspective of prosperity. When I think of prosperity, I may think of financial wealth or my possessions. I may even feel tempted to compare my life to someone else's and feel as though I come up short in comparison. Today, my understanding of prosperity grows. Feeling safe and secure in who I am is prosperity. Knowing I am gloriously made in the image of God is priceless. Realizing the abundance of the natural world and partaking of it is a gift. All of these are wonderful reminders that I reside in the kingdom of heaven. The more I appreciate the riches of the material world, the more I am aware of my greatest prosperity, my oneness with the divine. A scripture from Matthew says, look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? It fits so wonderfully with our theme of grace, the fact that that unlimited resource is there for us to draw upon. I liked how it talked about the idea of realizing the abundance of the natural world. And we started with that song, Blue Boat Home. That natural world is a grace that is all around us and always available, kind of easier to get into our consciousness than some other things. There are so many graces that come into our world. I urge you to be aware of them, make note of them, and enjoy them fully. So today we will move on to our speakers. And see if I can get myself together. I believe that Frosty was going to be speaking, but is unable to be here for some reason. And she was going to join us virtually. So Sylvia, you're going to be up first. Sylvia Prester is somewhat more new to our community, but she's just jumped right in, and she's got some good things to share. And we're looking at our gallery now, and as we come to the time, if we'll come back and spotlight the speaker, but we're glad for all of you are here, and we hope you'll enjoy the sharing from Unity of Payson members. And Sylvia, I give it to you.
I'm good. Can everybody hear me all right online? Okay. I'm Sylvia Prester, and my husband and I moved to Payson about 16, 17 months ago. I want to thank Reverend Neal for asking me to speak. And in order for me to tell you about my experience of grace or my awareness of grace, I have to tell you a little bit about my lack of awareness of grace. I was raised Episcopalian, which is a very liturgical church. For those who don't know, it's Catholic light. And I remember as a very little girl going to church with my mother, and this was in Northern Virginia. Stained glass windows, candles, organ music, the vestments, smells and bells. And I remember that and going to service with her. But what would happen after the reading of the gospel is that all the children would be marched out of the sanctuary and into Sunday school. And I really didn't like that. I wanted to be in the sanctuary. I felt disconnected. I was a very shy little girl, and I did not really was able to get, really interact with the other kids. So I felt very disconnected. And in my mind, I felt disconnected from God. And as far as grace was, the only thing I understood about that word was grace was the blessing you said before a meal, and my father would always say that, at dinner time, would say, for these and all his gifts, God's holy name be praised. But that was the extent of my understanding of what grace was. When I was 11 years old, after I was confirmed, my mom decided she wanted to go to a smaller church, a congregation, a group of people that had left the main congregation, and we met in a school cafeteria, no organ, no smells and bells, a couple of candles, and I really did not like it. I felt even more disconnected. And another thing that happened when I was 12 was that was that I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. And at that point, I really felt abandoned by God. I called God the absentee landlord of the universe. I believed in the existence of God, but I did not feel any connection, and I didn't feel that God really cared anything about me. Went on to high school. I was a very good student, graduated top 3% in my class, but I started experimenting with alcohol when I was in high school. And when I got to college, my freshman year, I drank every day and I got drunk every weekend. And my disconnect from God was, or my awareness of my of God was completely disconnected. Fast forward, I found myself in an AA meeting on the campus at George Mason University when I was 20 years old. And that was the beginning of my spiritual journey and starting to understand how blessed I was to have survived, first of all, and to start to make this connection with the God of my understanding. But grace was talked about in these 12-step groups, but it was what I remember, it was there but for the grace of God go I. And I still saw God as something external to me, as something, a grace that was external to me and not something that was, that was within me, that it was something that was bestowed. Or grace was, unmerited gift is another definition. Like, I wasn't worthy on my own of this gift of grace. And I understand in recovery programs how that works. It's about getting the ego right-sized, because people who are involved in substance abuse tend to have, you know, inflated egos with an inferiority complex, as they say. And so my understanding of grace, it took a long time to develop. But I did stay sober. I'm still sober today, 42 years later. And I started to study more and more about God. I actually got a certificate of theology from the University of South at Suwannee, Tennessee. But where I really started to feel a real connection to God was when I was interacting with my fellow recovery people, when I was interacting with people just in general, whether it be in church or just out in my community. It's that, you know, when two or three are gathered together, there's the presence of the divine. And about a year ago, I started studying to become a transformational life coach. And it's not directive coaching. My clients are not, I don't tell them what to do. It's about evocative coaching. And telling, you know, asking what would you love, and asking questions, and sharing experiences, and listening carefully. And I have been so blessed by the communities that I have been involved in. You know, this coaching community, recovering community, the people just that I meet in the gym. I've been so blessed, and after all, an awareness of the presence of the divine. And after all, one of the definitions of a blessing is grace. So, thank you.
So, thank you so much, Sylvia. And Rick, we'll put you off for just a minute because I understand that Frosty has been able to join us now. So if we can spotlight her, and we'll go ahead. And Frosty, are you ready to go? If you would unmute Frosty, and I think we'll get connected here. There she is. Frosty, I say go ahead and take it away.
Okay. Good morning, everyone present and on Zoom. Neil asked me to speak on grace. His earlier talks have been amazing, as usual, and so very helpful. There is something really awe-inspiring going on in this congregation. And for one thing, we love books, all kinds of books. We quote from them. I have been reading two amazing books, one by Anne Lamott on her usual topic of mercy, which is similar to grace. I love all her words of hope, gentleness, and love. Also, I have been reading about the Muslim faith and where all the different sects are heading. The author encourages Muslims to gather together worldwide and communicate on modernizing the religion toward egalitarianism, tolerance, and what kind of practices he thought Muhammad would want. He describes Muhammad. I don't think I have ever heard a detailed description of Muhammad and what he stood for and how he lived his life. I have understood that he wanted people to help and care for each other. I will talk more about that later. Those books were very interesting and informative. But then I listened to the Pulse program, as I usually do on Saturday nights on National Public Radio. I was all alone in our little home in Moon Valley in Phoenix. I love that. I love being alone here listening. I can concentrate on deep topics. The subject of the program was awe. Grace reminds me of awe and the moments called holy instants in the Course of Miracles. They are the miracle that change our lives, at least my life. I hope and trust that each of you are having holy instant miracles. Back to NPR, the scientist who was talking on the radio that night wrote a book he hopes will help people to release tension and encourage us to allow ourselves to seek awe. Dr. Keltner is his name, and it's a hard name to remember, explained how the experience of awe that astounds us and makes us suck in our breath changes the chemistry in our brains, our whole bodies. These changes help us stay well and possibly happy. And they do something else that is more profound. I have to wait for the book to come into the library, but I think it has to do with the limbic system and serotonin. I marvel at all the topics scientists study these days. Nothing seems too far out to study in great detail. These awe studies give me great hope because the findings so far are most encouraging. Because corresponding studies reveal that we humans are very, very social beings, that we function best when we work together. If we go to that awe state, our creativity blossoms and good action is the result. I know if the ego is involved, the creativity blossoms into trouble. And only with a miracle can be reversed. The idea is that awe can be experienced by us. If we know of an awe-inspiring story, we can tell it to our friends. Stories of someone who, despite many difficulties, has achieved the work of helping others might be an example. Rick Hinckley's work is like that. He constantly, without fail, looks for heroes in Payson and the world. Wherever he goes, he seeks communication, partnering, and most of all, humor. If you know Rick, you know what I mean. I am in awe of him and so many of our members and friends in Payson Unity. Neil and Donna and the prayer chaplains and the events teams inspire awe in me. People who overcome difficulties of all kinds inspire awe in me. People who put up with me inspire awe in me. I'm not kidding. Who cannot be inspired by seeing photos of galaxies? Awe is a bit more than being inspired by learning about black holes and planets that might have living beings. It is paying attention to the grandeur of the universe and feeling tiny, yet part of it all. And what is this about there might be more universes besides ours, which is infinitely huge? That was brought up recently. Having 9 billion people on this planet gives me a huge sense of awe. I hope I have enough grace to love every one of us. On the micro level, how many tiny beings live inside us? And what are they doing in there? That is stuff of awe for me. A sunset or sunrise, sparkling water, music, people we love, animals, trees, grasses, a simple lemon or orange, poems. I am in awe of cucumbers, beets, kale, and their perfection. The physical changes of awe take us to the holy instant. They restore our bodies and minds so you and I, can move forward and creatively go about the day with grace. There's a question to ponder. What have been your moments of awe and grace? Will you seek out awe-inspiring people and other experiences and be open to them? Anne Lamott says we are all so tired of this horror and that calamity. Yet she urges us to step back and breathe and find moments of grace and stay there a while. Then move forward and not get stuck. Dr. Keltner, who wrote Awe, The New Science of Everyday Wonder and How It Can Transform Your Life, wants us to remind young people to put down their phones and look for awe, for holy instances, and purposefully engineer awe into their lives. Engineering doesn't only have to be bridges and buildings. It can be connections. The term to remember is moral beauty. Moral beauty. Moral beauty. Wow. To have a young scientist coin that phrase struck awe in me. I hope it does in you too. Thank you, and thank you for being here. I love you all.
If you didn't hear it, Frosty, there was a little bit of a round of applause here. And so Rick Hinke will be our third speaker. So he's making his way forward. And Rick is one of our board members. He's been around a long time, and he's always got something to share. And I have an idea. Here he is.
I was at a meeting the other day. There were two of us across the table, Neil and I, and someone said, there's 150 years of experience here. I said, oh, gee, thanks. You know, I got to tell you, it finally got me. I caught it. I thought I was being very careful, masking, avoiding groups, avoiding large crowds, but I got it anyway, and maybe I had it all along, I don't know for sure. My immune system may have kept it dormant for a while. But I have a full-blown case now. And frankly, by the looks of you, I think you got it too. I look in those eyes, and I see those smiles, and then I see those restless hands wanting to do something for somebody else. So, we all got it, and it's called the G-bug. Yeah, and the full Latin name for that is gratia, and the Greek name is charis, and the Lakota name is Wakan, Takan, Kichi, Un, and in Hebrew, it's Ken. So it's recognized everywhere. And we talked about the symptoms, right? So our lips get rearranged, and our eyes get brighter. The G-bug is closely related to another bug called the K. Now, you're probably asking, okay, he's got it and we got it. What do we do about it? Is there a treatment for it? Well, don't go to your doctor. No help there. There's no medicines over the counter or prescriptions that are going to fix you over that issue. And we pretty much got to face the fact we got it forever, you know? So we might as well do the things that make us feel better. First step is acceptance and the fact that, you know what, having this is really a good thing. And just to be clear, the G-bug in English, as opposed to Lakota and Greek and whatever, is grace. You guessed that, right? You were way ahead of me. I can tell. So in Christian traditional philosophy, of course, grace is a gift from God for sinners. Yeah, okay, but there's more to it than that, lots more to it. Other biblical scholars say grace is action, power, influence that produces real practical outcomes in people's lives. That's what grace is. And I like the unity definition of grace, which is pretty complicated. It just says grace is love in action. Doesn't that work? That fits for me. That fits for me. And those actions, that love in action, is kindness to other people and forgiveness and all the other wonderful parts of that. So, how has my catching the bug changed me? Well, some of you might know that I have a little judgmental streak. I'm looking over at my minister here and many of you. And that judgmental streak wasn't doing me much good. I drive by a certain organization every day on my way wherever I'm going. And I look away as I drive by that organization because I, until recently, could not forgive them for what they've done to indigenous people, to children, to judgmentalness, other hateful things, wars and whatever over time. To include even recently the Supreme Court decision, which wasn't about the law, it was about the fact that 7 of 9 justices belonged to this organization, and I don't think they were free in their hearts to do the legal thing. I think they were affected by the beliefs of that particular organization. And then the bug got me, and I said, you know what? A, this is not doing you any good, and B, they feed people here in Payson. They run orphanages and schools and take care of people worldwide. And they bring people together and allow them to love and learn about grace. So why can't you look at them and see grace in them as well? So that's how grace, catching the bug, has affected me. And how did I come to this new understanding, besides catching the bug from all of you and seeing all of you do what you do? For the last year, I've been interviewing amazing people, some of you, food banks, Christian clinics, all sorts of things. And you know what? My sense that things are not good in Payson is wrong. There is great goodness in Payson, and you just have to be open to it. And I'm trying to be open to it. And a friend of mine just Monday night sat right in that chair and said that morning he meditated on kindness. And he said my awareness level was like super sensitive. And all day I saw kindness after kindness after kindness. And it was one of the great days of my life. It was wonderful. It was so powerful. And I thought, wow, there's a lesson in that. So let's make a pact. Let's let the symptoms of our bugness that we've caught and come out. So let's everybody smile and shining eyes and figure out what we're going to do in kindness to other folks. And then Mr. Tom has, I went to a famous guru. I wanted to be supported in my presentation because I knew these other two, Frosty and Sylvia, were going to be so doggone good that I had to do something. So there's the first slide. I got the bug, but then here's the guru that I saw. Yeah, our real neighborhoods would be like if each of us offered, as a matter of course, just one kind word. I don't think he was in the Himalayas. I don't think I had to go that far. And then there's one more. And the guru says, take the three-part path. Kindness, 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 kindness. And then the third is, if young folks can get it, us geezers can get it, right? I'm not speaking about you as geezers. I'm just talking about me out the other end. So that's where it's at. So if you will come to me, and we'll say this together now at the end, welcome grace and kindness. Welcome grace and kindness. Thank you. So it is.
Thank you to all of our three speakers today, Sylvia and Frosty and Rick. were sharing it, not just ideas, but their own lives with us. And for that, I am grateful. It's a grace for me to have that experience. We want to spend a little time in the quiet, just allowing some of the insights, some of the inspiration that has come to us to sink in. And I've asked another member of our congregation to lead us in a meditation today. We'll have a meditation song first. One of our favorite artists that we often listen to, Daniel Namad. Amen. And then Betty will lead us in a meditation.
Let's just allow ourselves to sink into a very quiet place, being supported by the chairs, glowing in the energy that's in this room at this moment. And let's take a nice deep cleansing breath, pulling in that grace, that breath of spirit. And just let any tension, any thoughts of the outside world just drift away. Allow yourself to be open to receive this morning as we've received the words, the messages. Allow your body to relax deeply. And envision in front of you a beautiful large crystal. And take just a moment to notice the facets on it and how they catch the light. How
it glows from inside. This crystal, this gift from spirit, has been given to you this morning. And envision a beam of light coming down from spirit, filling the crystal with brilliance. As Frosty said, be in awe of the light shining from this crystal. And now allow yourself to open your heart space to receive this grace, this light. Feel the warmth in your chest as the crystal shines its light directly into you. Feel the warmth spreading through your whole body, warming you, allowing you to feel so connected to all that is, to everyone in this room, to everyone in our larger community, to the great galaxies. Feel that sense of connection. You are divine. You are God in action. You breathe. You pulse. You dance in this circle of life. You choose life in this healing light ray. We all came here for a very special purpose. We are all needed. We are a very special piece of the puzzle with our gifts to give. And now allow someone to come into your mind that you know could use this gift of grace and light. And just as you received this light, envision now sending this out to that special person that you know is yours to bless. And spend a few moments sending this light. You are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. And as we move into a moment of silence, just bask in this light, this grace, this love, as you feel connected to everyone else here and in the larger community. Just allow yourself to be connected. We are co-creating this magical universe. We are part of the divine. Every time you have a loving thought, a kind action, you are building a more joyous world. Let's take a nice deep breath. Allow your consciousness to begin floating back into the room. But bring with you that sense of connection, that sense of being filled with light. Take another deep breath and just stretch your spine a little bit. Allow the light to move up your spine. Move hands and feet a little bit. And when you're ready, open your eyes and be back in this very blessed world.
Thank you, Betty. Are we back? Now it's time that we turn our attention to giving and receiving. You and your patient appreciate your gifts in support of this ministry. They also support beyond this ministry, beyond this room, beyond this organization, out into the community as well. And so we do truly ask you to know if it's yours to contribute to this. If it is, we are so appreciative. In a way that giving also becomes part of a giving and receiving cycle. And so you kind of get into that cycle as you give and you expect, and it happens, that you have a receipt. You may not know exactly where it's coming from, but as you give out kindness, as you give out service, as you give out of your financial abundance, it comes back. We have a slide that's up to give you how you can do that. If you go to unityofpayson.org, you can hit on a donate button, and you would easily be able to lend your support. You can also give lively.com, as you see this is on the slide, by text. It's an easy thing to do. And of course, here in person, the offering basket is being passed. Before we go on into our offertory song, we have an affirmation that we always say. Let's say it together. Freely we give, and freely we receive. And our offering song today, Spirit's Hymn.
In Spirit's love, my life is found, my breath, my light, my strength, my all. In perfect peace, on solid ground, I'll walk this world unharmed, unbound. Though tears draw near, I'm never far from Spirit's mind, from Spirit's heart. My comforter, my mighty tower, in Spirit's love, my life is found. In Spirit's eyes, I am whole. In flesh and bone, in mind and soul, unblemished in sweet holy light, I am God's and God is mine.
Wear this birthright like a crown.
In spirit's world, I stand amazed at what almighty power creates in every hue and every size. So it is, and so am I. I'll chart my life upon the waves of miracles seen every day. My ship will
and for the abundance that they represent. And so together we'd like to dedicate this offering. Together we say, divine love flowing through us blesses and multiplies all that we are, all that we have, all that we give, and all that we receive. We are abundantly prosperous. We are grateful and we give thanks. Thank you, Rick, who's also the usher. So, time to remind us of a little of the things that are happening at Unity of Payson, and there are a number. For the first time in a long time, there's not a special scheduled item on this thing, so I'm going to emphasize the things that happen regularly. That's that morning cafe happening every morning, except for Sunday morning, at 9:30. We ask you to join us on Zoom if you're able to do that. Of course, Wednesday at 4:30 and Sunday also at 4:30, Teresa does a Qigong moving meditation. Just one other thing I'll emphasize would be organic gardening. Although it seems like it's winter, there are things that need to be done for the organic garden. If you would like to get your fingers in the dirt, you'd like to get out into a really blessed place, if you don't know how to contact Ram and connect with him, let me know, and I'll get you connected. One other thing that happens once a month is a potluck, and next Sunday is our potluck time. So if you're here with us in person, you're going to have to do your own potluck if you're with us virtually, but if you're here in person, next month is a special time where we get to connect with each other in that very special way as we sit together for a meal. A couple other things that I want to mention. You've probably caught the idea. Well, I have a little sticker here. I don't know if you can see it. Kindness works for all. There's a kindness movement brewing here that Unity of Payson supports. This week there will be a meeting of a steering group, planning group for things to happen in the kindness conversations that we're having. Hopefully that'll spread abroad. It's not just a Unity of Payson thing. There are several people from different organizations and outside of Unity who have this at heart as well. And so we're doing some planning this week, but here's the thing to put on your calendar. Get out your calendar on March 12th at 3 p.m. in the afternoon. We're going to have a concert for kindness. March 12th, 3 p.m. in the afternoon. And our favorite recorded musician, I think, well, it's my favorite anyway, Daniel Namod will be here with us. He will be here in person. We're working with the Methodist Church, so in their sanctuary, Celebration Hall, I think they call it, will have a larger venue, and Daniel will be with us. Some other things might happen. He might even show up here in our morning service that day because it is a Sunday. Mark it down, Daniel Namod. It's been exciting working with him around the theme of kindness, and I expect great things to happen as a result of that. And stay tuned. A couple of other real quick things. Back on the table by the library section there, there are some other announcements. Just take a look at them. They're not things that are necessarily unity events per se, but they're things that you're going to want to know. And there's some kindness information, kindness something back there. Or see Rick, he's a Mr. Kindness. Well, I don't know that he's gotten there yet, but he's getting there real quick. So we come now to the time when we're going to close our Oh, before we do, next month is... Thanks for keeping this up there, Tom, because I would forget it otherwise. Next month is love, the theme of love. And we're going to look at it a little differently than we may have in the past. The theme for next month or next week is the origin of love. I'm going to speak about the origin of love. And so we're going to look at love very comprehensively and see how we can bring it home ourselves. So we've gotten through events, we've got all the PS, that we're going to go now to our time of closing when we sing the peace song. If you're here in person, why don't you stand up and join as you are able in a circle, and together we will be together. And those of you who are joining us online, just imagine yourself being a part of that circle. And so we connect in a very real way. The peace song, then the prayer for protection. And remember that after that, a 5-minute break. Stay with us if you're with us virtually, because we'll turn the camera here so that you can interact with the people who are here in person and they can interact with you for a little conversation afterwards. So the peace song, let's go for it.
Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me. Yes, there is peace on earth, the peace that is meant to be. With God as creator, family are we. Now we walk with each other in perfect harmony. Yes, peace begins with me, and this is the moment now. With every step I take, this is my joyous thought. I take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me.
And now the prayer for protection together. The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. And the presence of God watches over us. I am present wherever we are. God is, and all is well. Thank you so much for being with us. Stay around. Take a little bit of a break. Come back. We'll turn the camera on the audience here, and we'll have a chance to interact around our theme for this month and the speakers today. See you in about 5 minutes.
Space apart, so I can ice in between.
Yes.
Yes. Anyway, so yeah.
Thank you.
With this brain organ. And he just added expression. That's the most precious.
Notice that, and guess we're coming back to the conversation. Everybody, come on and join us.
Hang on, next door.
If you're online, I'm trying to get.
Before you can.
Signs. So lower the conversation level.
Would you like to do that, Ray? We need a lot of spending.
Why can it stay on the TV? We didn't need to do it. So welcome to the conversation afterwards. Dean, delighted to see you here. Teresa's here. Pulaski, Frosty, that's it from Berkstein. And we have several people that are here. So, if you're speaking here, just say your name so people can identify who you are if you speak on this side. As we usually do, the question is, what was, about the service, what was maybe insightful for you? What gave you a new idea? What inspired you? What would you like to say when you connect with the community as a whole here? So I think I'm just going to open it up. Somebody jump right in. You can feel free to unmute if you're online and jump right into the conversation. People are still eating, so we'll make it happen one way or another. Let me do this again. Let me offer Frosty, Sylvia, and Rick a chance for a last follow-up thing. Something you didn't say or something they might want to say in addition. So let's do that. Rick, are you still, are you here?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. Frosty, is there anything that you, that you'd like to add or just connect with people a little more directly? I see you're unmuted. She's still muted. So Frosty, come back at any time if you want to. So I'll go to Sylvia, who's right here in front.
Sylvia, anything you follow up with?
Just that my experience of the divine, you know, has gone from one of being totally distant outside of myself to one of being permeating me and everyone I meet and throughout nature. That is a shift that took a very long time.
And I'm just going to feedback to you a little bit. This is not something you just learned here at Unity of Payson. You've learned it over your growth and your spiritual journey.
Exactly.
And then found out, hey, it fits.
Yeah.
With us here.
Yes, exactly. I've had an experience with a Unity church in Northern Virginia. Not that I became a member, but I had attended a couple of services. And but just at that time, wasn't ready, wasn't at that place in my journey. But this feels very, very natural, and I feel I'm here.
Great. Anybody have a question or an interaction with Sylvia that you'd like to share?
Well, I just wanted, I have already spoken to Sylvia, but I just wanted, this is Betty. Let's see, I'm off camera. That I appreciated her willingness to give her story and her history and to be vulnerable. And I think people relate and connect with when we are really honest about where we've been or where we are. So thank you for that.
I will add on.
Talk.
I will add to that. I spoke to Sylvia and expressed the several different connections I felt with her. And she's quiet, and I have got to know her. And I felt like I got to know her so much better. And I think I don't always come to the membership services where they're sharing, and I got so much out of this one from all the people she spoke. And I thought, well, why aren't I doing this regularly? And it inspired me to do so. I always love whatever Rick has to say. He adds the levity, the fun, the, you know, let go, and such a surprise the way he entices us to believe something different was happening. And then they were such fun. And Betty's meditations. She always has something that touches me, even though sometimes I enter in with the depth. I need to work on that more. I'm reminding myself that I was touched there. And how come I can't even? Oh, Frosty added the esoteric part, and I can't remember specifically, but I just want the awe.
Yeah.
And I'm connected with some awes of my own. And I was reminded, I've been meaning to call for 2 years. Because we have some things in common. And I started to write down the books, but I was sitting in the back and I couldn't hear quite as well as I needed to tune in. So, Frosty, one of these days, I will call you. So, thank you for the opportunity.
Frosty, go ahead and jump in.
To express.
If you want to. Do that.
Oh, okay.
So somebody else, Rick, you got any follow-up you want?
Well, I would just say that what we're doing right now, just to encourage folks who are not part of Morning Cafe, Monday through Saturday, this is kind of what we do for a half an hour or so every morning at 9:30. So just tune in, you know, come in through the website like you did today,
through kindnessworks.org, worksforall.org, and come in that way too. And just, you know, we just hang out and talk, and there's a maybe a one-word story out of the Daily Word that we talk about, but it's really a nice connection. So I kind of want to do a little commercial, so to speak, for that. And the other quick thing for me is just, I just want to say thank you. I'm so grateful for being here and part of you and seeing the great works that you do for each other, for yourself. It's inspiring, and I've been to church forever. You know, great grandfather was a, you know, minister and all that stuff, you know, spoken German, the whole thing. But it's always been about the people. It's always been about the grace and loving kindness in the groups, not the dogma of the church, frankly. And so here at Unity is just, it just people can't help themselves. It just leaks out, which is great.
Thanks, Rick. The floor is open, so if you'd like to jump in on anything, feel free to do so.
The idea of the facets of grace, that to me was important. Just like grace is a word and it means only one thing, and being open to it meaning lots of things. And enjoying that.
Thanks, Charlotte. Anybody else? Jean and Barb, we're welcome to, you're welcome to jump in if you like. You don't have to. Jean is in Texas. Barb's here in Payson. Ross is in Moon Valley, like we say, but we're kind of spread around. So let's go ahead and bless each other.
Amen.
Brief conversation, but like Rick said, you can get conversation 9:30 every morning. On Zoom, and that's a wonderful time. See you all soon. Blessings, and thanks again to all of those who shared this morning. Betty, the meditation, and Sylvia, and Frosty, and Rick, their messages, and we are so great. See y'all.
Amen.